For many members of the class of 2021, their educational journey began at one of the 9 Duncanville ISD elementary schools. Their years on these campuses were filled with fun times on the playground, classroom parties and activities, teachers who nurtured and cared for them, theme days and dress-up days, classmates who became friends, and so many more rich memories. Sadly, our current situation has not allowed them to enjoy many of the normal activities that culminate senior year. This video allowed some members of the class to pay homage to some of the people who helped them along their journey, reminisce about some of their favorite childhood memories, and relive those priceless years that shaped and molded who they would become. We invite all of the members of the Duncanville High School Class of 2021 to take this walk down memory lane and remember days gone by.
That cafeteria food in elementary school used to be so
the good. Breakfast.
The breakfast.
The breakfast. Them little muffins that they would give us.
The waffles. The cinnamon rolls.
Mm-hmm.
The strawberry milk.
Right.
I did the relays. I did the softball throw. I won every time. I'm telling y'all. I won every single time. I remember.
I remember it was hot.
In tug of war?
Oh, yeah. It was hot.
Oh, yeah. I did tug of war, too.
Everybody
gets dragged.
All dirty.
We had the little magic t-shirt.
Yeah. Oh my God.
I still have the t-shirt.
I probably got it somewhere.
I remember it because you know how you like have to get your momentum going. You had to like run and then throw the softball. I remember I was running and there was a hole and I like twisted my ankle and I fell. I was the last kid out. I was so embarrassed. I didn't cry though. I was a G.
We watched the Karate Kid.
Yeah,
I remember.
And we did Cars, I think, once.
Mm-hmm.
And
the
we were
Express.
Yeah. Yep. Then we'd go with popcorn and a Capri Sun.
Yeah.
I remember that.
Remember the early act first night?
Oh my god. Where they would bring the knife and the sword
of that
and you would
knife.
Have to kneel down thought, and they'd like put you with the sword.
I thought they were gonna cut me.
Me.
What happened to the yellow slide?
Oh, they took it.
Yo, they really messed it up.
They gave a boost.
I remember that little red thing.
That one doesn't hit the same.
Me and Eveline and Angie would play on the red thing.
Reading up in the nook over there.
Oh, yeah,
that was so fun.
With the beanbags and everything.
And then it would be, was it only on Fridays that they had the popcorn and the pickles?
Yes, you had to bring your little $1-$2 go get
exactly.
your pickle.
Oh my gosh. I don't know where they got them pickles from, but
they were good.
It was real good. Real tasty, real good.
Nice crunchy and sour.
Ooh. And it wasn't too sour.
It was too sour. But it was good. It was
sour enough.
Bro, no, stop playing with me because this is my food.
Does it still have the stamps in it? Oh, no, they took them out.
They have pictures, right? They have pictures. Oh, look at the letters. They're so big.
They used to be so small.
What? food. Yeah. We get like French toast sticks. Yes. We get cereal. Thank we get orange juice. Like it was like the good breakfast food. And I was like,
that part, yes.
I always come to breakfast. Like that was my thing. And my mom would come too.
Oh, yeah. I remember in the library. I remember the first time I went to the library where you buy stuff.
The book fair?
Yeah, the book fair.
You didn't sell me nothing at the book fair.
I asked my mama for all her money.
We just thought we was balling.
We're like $2.
$2.
Like, oh, my fifth
pencil.
That
didn't
five.
That was, no, that was 5 cents.
50 cents.
The pointers and all that stuff.
Wow. I had a blue point.
I forgot. I got
purple ones
too.
You remember when they did like the Polar Express?
Yes, in kindergarten?
Yes.
You come up in your pajamas.
We had the hot chocolate. Once again, it was good. I don't know. Everything that they got, it was good. It was real good. Everything. And like we would go up under the desks and like have flashlights, be reading books.
Oh my gosh. Share the memories.
Right. That was so much fun.
We also had sock hops. It was the last Friday of each month. We had sock hops and we would pay $1 to go into the gym. And they would have snacks and music. And there was one time where they put a bouncy house inside the gym. And, you know, they would let us go into the bouncy house. And then after that, they would let us grab snacks for free. So we didn't have to pay for snacks.
I remember I would always jump these squares. Or like, I would go like...
That
like,
would always make me mad. That right there.
Really?
Yes, the fact that it would
say... I would always
do this. Yeah, that's what I would do.
Okay, so my favorite teacher was probably Miss Northcutt. She was my kindergarten teacher. And I don't know, just the environment. It's the very first year of being in school and she made me feel comfortable and...
My favorite teacher was Miss Green. It was my first year in Duncanville District, and she was just so nice to me. She didn't even know me, and she was just really nice for no reason.
I think my favorite teacher, probably either Miss Nava or Miss Flores. Mm-hmm. Mostly because I had really like good memories in those classes. I feel so bad for them because I was really mischievous as a little girl.
I think my favorite teacher was Coach Graves because he always like motivated me and like he made PE fun.
I'd have to say my favorite teacher was Miss Rodriguez because her learning style, like the way she would teach was just amazing. Like I don't know if y'all knew, but she would teach us songs to go with the lesson. Oh so, like, if it were homophones, it'd be a song about homophones. And it was just fun, even though I was a troublemaker for sure. But YOLO.
I was not.
But, yeah, Miss Rodriguez for sure.
I have two really because they're both equal for me. I would say Coach Graves and Miss Benson. Because Coach Graves, he always made the gym class hype. We always had games, fun games and stuff. And then Miss Benson, since I was in choir, we always had fun in like rehearsal and then all our concerts and stuff. So yeah, it was fun.
While I was here, my favorite teacher was Miss Valentine. Like in fourth grade, I loved going to her class. Like she made coming to school like I said, it made coming to school fun. Like the activities that we would do in her class and like just the way she taught in general, one of my favorite teachers, like out of my whole entire school career.
Like not only did she teach us in school, but she taught us like just how to act pretty much. Like whenever we would be too loud in class, she wouldn't just yell over us or tell us to be quiet real loud, none of that. She would say like, she would just start talking like slowly quieter and quieter. Until we realized like she wasn't talking no more, so it kind of like helped us realize, okay, I don't necessarily need to yell in order to get my voice heard.
My favorite, I actually have three. So it's Coach Graves, Miss Benson, and Miss Ewan. I'll start with Miss Ewan. Miss Ewan because she built a bond with me outside of school. She was like my mom, the mom teacher. So that's that. And Coach Graves, he was just like so fun, and you could always laugh at him. you're always laughing with him and around him. And then Miss Benson, I really thought I could sing, so she like motivated me to like, you know, I thought I was Alicia Keys when I was in the fourth grade. So she was just so fun to be around, and yeah.
I think probably the teacher that had like the biggest impact on me was Miss Rodriguez, because she's the one that like made me feel the most comfortable. Because she, like, I think I would always call her mom. And she just had, like, she's the one that I've seen the most as well, and like the one I probably have talked to the most. But if not her, it's probably Miss Jameson, my kindergarten teacher. She dealt with me a lot because I would always get in trouble in her class for whatever reason. But I think the most like thing she did was just like, she was just like a grandma to me. Like, that's the biggest part, like, about her. She's just, like, a grandma. But I wish I could have, like, seen her at least once more before, you know, she retired.
I really can't give any advice to my younger self. Like, everything... No, not even the knife. Because... Those bad things happen to me for a reason, and you have to learn from that, you know? Like, I got my ear pulled, and that taught me discipline. I controlled my anger in third grade. Well, after third grade, I had to control my anger. Fourth grade was when I learned about lying. And I was like, okay, so I'm going to do that a lot less.
I think I would tell my younger self to enjoy the moment and not think so far ahead. Even in like first grade, I would think, oh, I wonder what I'm gonna be like when I'm 18 and I graduate. Like, what is gonna be different? But I would never, like, rarely would I like be up in the moment while it was happening. So like things, events that we would have at school, like Mayfest or like the assemblies we would have, I would always think, oh, what am I gonna be like next year? Or what am I gonna be like in intermediate or stuff like that? So I think, if I could talk to my younger self, I think it would be weird, by the way, but I think I would just say, you know what, just don't be thinking so far ahead to the point where you freak yourself out and you don't get to enjoy the thing that's happening around you right now.
Advice I would give you elementary kids is, no matter what your dream is, you have to go for it, you know. Don't lose focus. If you want to be an astronaut, if you want to be a doctor, if you want to be a lawyer, go for it, because every dream is reachable. And, you know, get your head straight. Don't lose focus. Hang around with your friends, you know, have fun, but also never lose focus.
Something I probably have to tell my younger self is to enjoy being young and carefree, because elementary school, that was like some of my best years, because everything was just so easy back then.
What's it called? I would tell my younger self to like literally never stop reading, because like as I kind of got older, I kind of grew out of reading books, and like I would just be on my phone more. But like reading was always a good way to like pass the time and like just kind of escape into another world for a while. And I wish I still like had that trait like when I was younger, so I would tell myself to never stop reading, never stop picking up books.
Advice I'd give for my younger self would be, don't let yourself be influenced by others, because that's the reason why I would get in trouble, because I would think that the bad kids were cool, so I'd be influenced by them and then do it myself. That's why I would get in trouble. So, but yeah, don't let yourself be influenced by others.
I think the word that will describe my elementary experience is growth, because when you start off, you are like 4 or 5 years old, and then you end up being about 10. And then from there, it's just growth from there. So I think elementary school gives the foundation of how you are going to be for the rest of your school experience until you reach secondary education.
Elementary school was a very fun and safe place for me. I remember hanging around with all my friends, you know, at the playground. You know, it was just a very fun time, and the fact that we had amazing teachers to help us with our education made it even better.
So, when I think of elementary, the word that comes to mind is adventurous. I say that because when I go back and think about what actually went on in elementary, it was nothing but pure adventures. It was so many trips that we took, the field trips, things that happened in playgrounds, the classrooms. It's just all filled with adventures, and it's just something that will always stick with me for like the long run, because I don't know, it's just something that, you know, it's a part of like every child's like childhood is their elementary school experience, and it's just so unbelievable that we're at this point now where we're entering adulthood.
A word I would use to summarize elementary school would be iconic. We come in as kindergartners who don't know anything, and we go out as fourth graders who know all our foundations for the rest of our life. And we look back and we don't even think about that. We just look back and see ourselves as kids, and while we're here, we're just wishing for the year we graduate. And now that we're graduating, we don't want to be there, we want to be here. And it's just iconic.
Because a lesson learned should be a lesson shared. Now, I'm glad that I have only made this mistake of striving for something that is in the light of eternity, not important, for just 1 year. I can't imagine if I had learned this at 50 or at the end of my life. And here's the lesson. Have no regrets in the 16th second. Nothing is more important than your healthy relationships. Nothing. Not your goals, not your successes. And here's why. Relationships are where we get to influence, impact, and change people's lives. Your life cannot be meaningful without them.
I am so proud of you. It's just gonna be amazing. I'm just happy I got a chance to see you come back and see it. Someone's keeping in touch. I want to see you graduate from college.
What do you want in your marriage? What do you want with your son and your daughter? What do you want in your health? What do you want financially? Like, how much money do you want to make a year? What do you want to drive? How do you want to live? Stop just waking up like an accident. What do you want? And then once you find out what you want, spend the rest of your natural life waking up and going after it.
forever gone away. It's so hard to say goodbye to yesterday. And I'll take